here we are. We're in Barry's very glamorous garage, which doubles up as one of the popular bars on Boschergate. You might have seen it sometime. Maybe you've been there. It's the one where he dresses up as a girl and does lap dancing. Isn't that right, Barry? Okay. I've just run, was it just short 2 miles in half an hour? Was that what it was?
No, you did just over 3 miles in half an hour.
Just over 3 miles in half an hour. I'm getting all muddled up with the time.
The problem I'm having is I'm getting up very early, and if I'm not getting out early enough in the day, I'm absolutely knackered before I even start. But I don't have a problem with the distance. This coming weekend, I'm actually going to run, with Barry and I, I'm going to run the Cumbrian Run route proper. As I told you before, I've done a 13-miler, but we're actually going to run the 13.1 miles of the Cumbrian Run route this weekend and use it for a timing. I think I'm slowly losing. I felt as though when I did all the work and stuff, and I went to and I had the problems with my knee and I actually stopped running, I felt as though I actually put very slightly a little bit of weight back on. But I don't know whether I did or not. Do you think I did then? What are you laughing at?
Laughing?
Hey?
I've got wind.
You've got wind?
He gets to his kids' wind.
Well, he's used to it. He talks out his arse all the time, this one, doesn't he? I get paid for it. What's your excuse?
Just because I've got a split personality.
You certainly have. Oh, you have, haven't you? So that's that. So I'm getting slightly nervous about it all, but it'll be fine. And as I say, I can only do what I can do, and I'm going to do my best. That goes without. Okay. Was that your wind again?
No, it wasn't.
God almighty, it's unbelievable. There's a hell of a draft coming through here, I can assure you. Right, he's got his Lycra shorts on again. Have you got a couple of pairs of socks down there or what? Blimey.
Right, so here we are. It's video diary week 9. And yes, I'm at the chiropractic centre once again here in Carlisle. This is Christoph, who you've met before on previous video diaries. And today is my evaluation, because I've been coming here probably about 8 weeks now, About 8 weeks. And Christoph's been helping me with all the corrections, the adjustments that we've talked about before on one of the previous video diaries. And that, combined with all the other people I've been seeing, and all the exercise I've been doing, has more generally turned me into a much healthier person. And, of course, a much svelte-like figure, as you can see. You see? Yeah. Vanessa, who's on the camera today, she thinks, he's a bit all right. Just said that to me just a minute ago. No, I'm only kidding. Anyway, she's got taste. Anyway, so Christoph's here, and we're doing the evaluation. So this is kind of like the result of the work that you've done on me now, isn't it?
Essentially, yeah. When you first started, we took measurements of what was going on with your posture, your alignment, your movement. And after a period of somewhere between 6 and 12 weeks, we would expect your body to be able to straighten up and improve. And so today, what we've done is remeasure to see what we've got improving. Okay, the camera might not pick up the lines here, but in short, your posture was distorted, so the top half of your body was leaning off to the right with your head and shoulders high, but so too was your pelvis. First thing then that we noticed today is that your pelvis is now level, so rather than being high on the right-hand side, we can now rub out that distortion, so that's straightened up nicely. Going along with the pelvis twisting like that, we noticed that your right leg was actually shorter. It was shorter by about an inch when you were lying down, whereas today it's less than a quarter of an inch shorter. So it's not that we've made your legs longer, it's just that by taking the distortion out of the middle part of your body, you're now more balanced down through your legs. Interesting then, as the balance in the legs has improved, so too has the reflex. The reflex down at your ankle on the right side was a bit dull, so what that tells me is that the nerve coordination down there wasn't as good as it needed to be. If we look then, there are various aspects of the movement in your spine which are better. I'll focus on two important ones. I've drawn the arrows here for the side bending in your spine. You were able to bend to the right fairly well, but you were restricted on the left. Whereas today now, we've probably seen an extra maybe 2 or even 3 inches more movement down the left-hand side. And then similar going on in your neck. In fact, both ways, your neck was only rotating to about 80 degrees. It should go to 90.
Right.
So in both ways, you've probably got an extra 5 to 10 degrees of movement.
So here I am now. So for the benefit of the camera and for people watching the video, the website, can you sort of give me a rough idea? Can you do a rough idea of how I was? Is it visible how I was when I came to see you? You said my head was slightly to the right, was it?
Yeah.
So if I'm standing here,
I stand you there,
pretty good now, then.
Your shoulder was higher there and your head higher there, and you were standing over that way. You are still a little like that, but less so. Unfortunately, the one I can't show is that your pelvis which was twisted up like that, is now levelled out.
Right.
That's it would be easier to see it in your shoulders, but certainly looking from behind, I could see it. Yeah. You know, that's there.
And a lot of people are like this, who haven't been to necessarily see a chiropractor, they could be walking along in sort of this sort of way.
Yeah, that is a very common thing. When the spine is distorted, the body therefore has to distort as well. And traditional thinking is that it's normal for us to be distorted in some way, but in fact what we're finding with more and more people we look after is that actually it's probably not as normal as we think. Yeah. It's probably because so many of us are distorted.
Yeah.
You know, and then I guess the only other thing I want to show you in here, which I think is fabulous, is that you're carrying a lot of extra muscle tension through your pelvis there, through your low back, but also through both sides of your shoulders, which is all cleared out now. So what that means is that the muscles, that the postural muscles of your shoulders, neck, and also your pelvis, which were straining and working too hard,
right,
are now relaxed and back to their normal tone.
Done anything for hair loss, do you?
Can't
solve everything, I suppose.
No, I guess not.
And we're here at the moment, the sheep mount. You can see that there, hopefully. You can see that all right on camera? Okay, there's the sheep mount, and we're going to start just up the road here. We're going round Pitts Park once, then we're coming up here, Devonshire Walk, along Castle Way, past the castle there, back to Dakar Road, and then past the tennis courts. Then we come across here to the Sand Centre, round the Sand Centre. We're going over the Eden Bridge. We're going up Stanex Bank into Rickaby Park. Next piece of paper, here's one we made earlier on. Through Rickaby Park, and then we come up to Linstock Bridge and Linstock and up to the roundabout. This is part of the route I've run before, you may remember, on previous video diaries. But then we used to head back into Carlisle, but now today is my first time of going along here. The road to Brampton, we're going along here, then we head into Crosby-on-Eden. This is about the halfway point. I'm told at the halfway point approximately there's a hideous, horrible, very steep hill that we've got to go up to, so really looking forward to that, obviously. Back here around the loop again, then you're on the way back, follow the same route, this is time with Brampton behind us, coming heading back towards Carlisle to this roundabout here, back through Linstock, through Rickaby Park, and then sheet number 3, which is here. And then once we get back through Rickaby Park, Stanex, near the University of Cumbria as it is now, it used to be Cumbria Institute of the Arts, of course, but now the University of Cumbria, and through Stanex, down Stanex Bank, over the Eden River, around the Sand Centre, there's Hardwick Circus Roundabout. It looks a bit like Barry's mate Dave. And then we go around the Sand Centre, right the way around, past the tennis courts, we're back towards Bitts Park. We're running up here around Bitts Park behind the castle, across where we were running in the opposite direction, that was the start line, and then we go past there, and then we're heading round to the sheep mount, and then through a gate into the sheep mount onto the running track, and we run down the back straight to the finish line, and that is it. So we've just done it, and it was encouraging. Was it a reasonably good time, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was good.
Okay,
it's not Monday.
Eh?
It's not Monday yet.
It's not Monday yet, no. Not Monday, not quite Monday. Yeah, it's a bit dark in here. It's not quite midnight. No, it was a reasonable time, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was good. Really good.
Okay. I thought about possibly doing another Cumbrian Run, another 13 miler, before race day, which is 4 weeks today, but you said no.
No, absolutely not.
So I'm going to be doing more training and keeping fit and just generally running, but I'll take Barry's advice because he knows best and not do it over 30. So the next one will be the race day itself, and see if I can, you know, try and beat 2:18 on the day if I can. Speak to you next week. 2:19, I was so near. 2:19, I was so near.